here's another part that's very similar on Mercedes 1975 to 1995. That's the throttle pedal. Notice it's got this rubberized coating on it, and it's hinged here at the bottom. Now, these can have problems, believe it or not. And when I was driving just the other day, this is my recently acquired 300 SE, I was driving it, and the throttle pedal, you know, I had to, it was kind of sticking, and then I'd push, and it would delay the acceleration. If you find your car is doing that, you need to stop and check it out. Now, what I'm going to do is we're going to get down inside here. I've already pulled the carpet. We're going to take a look at what's going on with the throttle pedal inside this W126. I think you can see where it's catching when I push on the throttle. See, it's real sticky right there. And then when I push, notice the pedal is slipping off to the side. Well, if I pull the pedal back, it's not even connected. This part has broken off right here. Now, this is very common on the 86 and newer models. So I'm going to pull this out, and we're going to take a closer look at it. As long as I'm here, I'm going to show you how to remove this pedal from the car. It's really quite easy. There's a clip right here. You're going to need a straight blade screwdriver. And all you have to do is just pry this clip right out. Like that. Once the clip is out, then you can just pull the pedal right up and remove it from the car. Once again, now you can see that something is broken off right here on this pedal assembly, and it's stuck on this throttle rod because the movement here is fine. So the problem was with the pedal itself. Here's the pedal I just removed. If you look, you can see where this part right here just broke right off. You can see it's all plastic. There's no hinge. The hinge is in the plastic itself. So years of pushing back and forth just broke this off. The older style, I'm going to show you now. Look at the older style. It's quite a bit different. It's on a pin and it pivots. So you don't see as much problem with these like on the W114, W115, the W116, the W107, 123 models had this style. But then beginning with the 126s and on up into the 201 and 107, they used, or the 124, they used this style. So this is the one you have to watch out for. These do wear out. They don't necessarily break away like these, so both of them can have problems. But the newer style is more prone to breaking like you see here. Now I'm going to go ahead and get a new one and install it back in this 300 SE. Installation on this newer style, a little tricky. Notice that that's not a circular hole. It's got a little notch out on one corner. There's also a little pin right on the outer point of this throttle rod. So you have to take the pedal, line that notch up, and then see what I've done. I've slid it on. Now I have to rotate it all the way around and then slide it down onto the hinge point. And this is where you have to get a little bit of a contortion here. Hold that down while you line up this little clip and then shove the clip into place like that. And look at that, it's installed. Now look at the movement. See how smooth that is? There's no play and there's no notchiness at all. What a difference. I mean, now when I push on the throttle, it's not catchy. It doesn't slip. You know, I didn't even enjoy driving this car, and it really is a safety issue because you get a delayed throttle response. But the throttle pedal is not the only problem you might have with your throttle system. You have to be concerned about the linkage. Let me explain. Take a look at the throttle linkage on this M103 engine. Look at how many ball joints there are. You've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and you've got 1, 2, 3 pivot points. Actually, 4 if you count that one. And no matter what model it is, on these older Mercedes, you need to be lubricating this linkage once a year. I've seen some really bad situations happen on these cars, even the throttle sticking in a wide open position. Now look here, someone has lubricated these previously, but they've used some sort of a grease, like a lithium spray grease. I do not recommend grease because grease can get gummed up and dirty and create a sticking problem as well. This is my favorite tool right here for lubricating throttle linkage. It's a curved tip syringe filled with transmission fluid. This is Dextron transmission fluid, typical of what you use in these older Mercedes, so everybody's going to have this handy. If you don't have a curved tip syringe, you can use a Q-tip, but you're actually having to get in, and you can see here I'm having to work the tip in around underneath the ball on some of these to get the lubrication actually where it needs to be. Now, automatic transmission fluid is great lubricant. It holds up well to moisture. It doesn't collect a lot of heavy crud that develops in the engine. So I've done a couple more videos on lubrication. I'm going to put links below in the show more description of this video, along with some other links you may find helpful as related to the 103 engine, if you're interested particularly in that. We also carry a special lubrication kits on my website, as well as these syringes if you're not able to find these locally. So if you're going to own a 75 to 95 Mercedes-Benz, you need to pay attention to the throttle pedal and linkage system.